Hey guys, it's Delicacy here with another speed build, this time in the beautiful and pristine world of Aluna Island, which I absolutely adore. I love that the world is quite small, so you can be kind of intimate with your Sims game, which is really cool, and I love that it's like a very coastal town. And also, it's completely blank, so you can do whatever you like with it. If you I'm not aware of already, it's designed or created by James from The Sims Supply. You should definitely check it out because it's beautiful. And there's also the opportunity to upload your lots to his website, which you can then kind of share with everyone else as an alternative to the exchange. And yeah, you might even get your house in one of his videos, which is pretty cool, I believe. But anyway, saving my game there, and I'm probably going to pause a little bit throughout this because I was actually building this on and off a lot this week because I was going to uni as well, so I had to kind of keep coming back to it. So if there's some awkward pauses, that is why. But basically, I'm just kind of using a little bit of constrained floor elevation here to kind of, I suppose, just change the wall heights and kind of begin this cliff build because there, I think there are three levels to this house. Yeah, there is actually three levels that kind of work their way down from ground level down towards the lower road there, which is pretty cool. But I've never done a cliff build before, so I had to actually look up one of James's tutorials or a couple of them to kind of teach myself how to do that. The tutorials are really good, and I kind of learned how to do it that way. I did, however, towards the end, have a little bit of trouble with some of the stairs. They were glitching out a lot with the Sims when I player tested the house, so I did have to ask James to kind of help, and he may have fixed it for me. But yes, it's all working fine now, thank goodness, and it is available for download in the description down below if you would like it in your own game. But I do advise, because it is built on a cliff, it does have to go on this specific lot in the world. I'll also number that in the description down below as well. Here I am pausing again. I'm not sure why. I'm obviously doing something to do with, I don't know, Twitter or listening to Spotify or something like that, which I tend to do a lot in my videos. But yeah, just building up the walls here, and it's kind of starting to take its form now, although it does change a little bit. But yeah, I don't know, there's not much else to say at this point in time. Oh, I was trying to do like a cover over the balcony, but it didn't really work because I couldn't get the right height of floor tiles, and it was just kind of being annoying. So in the end, I might put a bit of roofing over it. I can't exactly remember, but I'm pretty sure I do. Just kind of experimenting here again with some more roofing, and I don't know, it's all about experimentation, especially with this cliff build. I kind of made the outside shell of it, and once it was kind of in that three level exterior, I suppose, I then kind of start taking chunks out of the side and rejigging it, creating some balconies, and also I create a pool that kind of goes underneath the house as well, which is pretty snazzy in my opinion. But that was awkward as I was trying to cough whilst I was laughing, and it came out sounding really bad. Anyways, it's quite late at the moment. It's 2:35 a.m. in Australia, and it has been the most beautiful weather today, as in not your usual good weather that you would expect to be sunny and perfect. It was more like our first day of rain here in Melbourne, and it was so exciting because I actually went for a jog, and then it started like a massive thunderstorm, which was awesome, except the fact I was kind of scared I was going to get struck by lightning. But it is okay because I am talking now, so I'm fine, obviously. But I love running in the rain. There's something about it that's really fun. But yeah, you can see kind of definitely the form is becoming more obvious now, and having a little bit of trouble with CFE there, constantly putting those triangular walls that stick up back down again, and it can get really complicated. And if you don't keep an eye on things from the very beginning with you know, keeping every level really flat to the ground and getting those four wall level heights perfect, then later down the track you can kind of run into a bit of trouble, which I think is what happened for me. But it is okay now, which is good. Very good. Also, I put up a video just before this one asking for some questions for a Q&A video, question and answer video that I'm going to be releasing soon. And already I'm really surprised at the feedback. There's a lot of fantastic questions, which I'm really excited to answer and hopefully get to know you guys a little bit better. And yeah, so that should be good. You can definitely check that out if you'd like. And I always use the same carpet just as kind of the initial carpet of the flooring. It's the one on the level below that's like that spotty carpet. I don't know if you guys find that you always go to the same carpet that's kind of like your stock carpet for the house that you use just until you actually put your, you know, the final product carpet in, I suppose. But I always go for that one. I don't know why. Actually, I think it's the first in the catalog. That's probably why. But yeah, just putting some exterior paint on here as well, just to kind of, I guess putting all of this kind of cream paint all over it, I can kind of get an idea of how I might section off the house in terms of where I'm going to put windows and where the different contrasting wallpapers are going to be. It just, I don't know, it makes it easier for me to look at if I kind of block out some of it, I guess. But yeah, I really love that front room there with those windows. It's just like an entire glass front, which comes out or turns into a lounge room, which kind of overlooks the entire ocean, which I thought was really cool. Kind of a 180 degrees view of it, which in real life, if I could live there, oh, it would be amazing. Oh, I would love that. One of my friends actually lives in a house on a cliff and that overlooks the ocean, and it's stunning. It actually has kind of a similar it actually has a similar view to what this house actually has in The Sims, which is pretty insane. But yeah, it's beautiful. And yeah, just kind of getting to the point now where I'm almost ready to put a roof in. And here we go, we've jumped forward a little bit. I know a lot of you guys say you really don't like me cutting forward in the build, but the problem is the video would go for a really long time. Like, I think this video is over 40 minutes, and if I hadn't done some cutouts, it was over an hour. So, yeah, basically that's why I do that. And you can see here the initial kind of wallpapers I was going with. I was going to go for like browns and kind of this rusted orange metal that I thought kind of reflected the beach quite nicely. But then in the end, I actually started working on the interior, and I don't know, the interior took me in the direction of, I suppose, a more Scandinavian inspired design, which was a lot lighter, and I thought this exterior was much too dark. So I actually changed it quite considerably to more kind of softer woods and some soft blues and a very vibrant red. But in any case, I guess this is interesting to see. It's definitely got a very rustic look about it, and I'm really, really trying out and being very experimental with a few different tile textures, lightening it up a bit here with a cream color, trying out some bricks and stones and tiles, and wow, I really did try a whole heap of things. But yeah, I don't know. Sometimes if I'm struggling on the exterior, I'll actually go on the interior and just see how I go from there. I actually really like how it's looking around about now with that orange and then the blue, not floorboards, the blue like weatherboard on the outside or paneling. That was pretty cool. I could have definitely gone in that direction, but I didn't. Maybe another time I'll go back to that for a different build. But yeah, I don't know. It just, the interior would have had to be more dark and stark, I think, than the lightness it does have at the end. And I love the pool. You can see it there that kind of sneaks under the house, which is really nice. You can get some shade if you're a more pale skin tone, perhaps. I don't know. But yeah, also making some walls in here and moving the camera around a lot, sorry. Yeah, that's all right. That's all right. You can still see what's going on. And putting in some floorboards, this is when I start realizing that I'm kind of going for a more lightish Scandinavian design with the light floorboards, and I go for quite a light carpet as well here, which I really like that texture, that carpet texture. It's not the usual kind of fluffy carpet. It's more of a beachy looking carpet, or I don't know, a linen-y looking carpet, which I think is pretty cool. Also, those tiles from Late Night Expansion are probably my favorite tiles. I love them. They're just really nice and simple and gray and big and modern looking, which really suits so many different houses. I mean, if you watch my other videos, you'll notice that I use those quite a bit. But yeah, putting in the kitchen here, and I couldn't remember how to get a triangle piece of floor tile for ages, and I don't know why it took me so long, but I was Googling what is the triangle floor tile command. I think it's command F, which is control, no, command T, and that would be control T on a PC. Yeah. Oh, I am so excited. I get my new Mac soon. Cannot wait. And I'm going to be blacking out the screen just now because of some YouTube action there that I couldn't actually show because it has some of my private details. But anyway, back into it again. And I think this is where I start changing it up a little bit. We start going for a lighter design. We introduce some of the horizontal weatherboard instead of the vertical. And yeah, I liked this initial color. It's kind of like a light earthy brown, a natural brown, which is pretty nice. And trying out like a salmon color and an orange color and blue color and all the colors of the rainbow, I suppose. And I don't know, I wanted to go with blue because the sea is blue and I thought blue was cool, but I actually changed that in a sec to a more muted blue, I believe. And a lovely shot of red as well. Here we are putting the red in. I think this is pretty Scandinavian looking, but you guys decide in the comments below. But yeah, just putting in some of those balustrade textures there, which is so frustrating because you kind of have to do them all individually. You can't just eyedrop the whole half wall fencing in one go. It's kind of annoying, but you know, there's an improvement that will maybe, I don't know, be changed in The Sims 4, hopefully. That would be pretty cool. And putting more red here. It actually looks like a orangey red there, but it is changed to more of a reddy red color. That was the worst description ever, but you get my drift. Here we go. This is more of a red. It's a bit more darker and richer, which I thought was nice. Doing a little bit of landscaping around here. I thought it was really important to make sure there were lots of rocks along the side of the house here, seeming as though it was on that rocky cliff. I love the rock detail, actually. It's probably one of my favorite parts of the whole house. And putting some foliage throughout there. I really like that. And I love those windows at the bottom there that kind of sneak through behind that foliage in that little hidey hole section of the house. And also, of course, the plants kind of stick through some of the walls, so kind of have to shift those back. And yeah, putting in some showers, putting in some more windows. These windows are actually from Into the Future. They're not the base game windows, but they would easily be replaced by the base game windows as well. Some nice white doors there, or as my mother would say, you must pronounce it as white. She's always told me that since I was very, very little. And yeah, just having a bit of a spin around the house here. And I think at this point I'm thinking what colors I want the exterior, but I still go back once more after working on the interior a little bit more. I went for timber tops on the kitchen counters. I love timber tops in kitchens. Oh, they're beautiful. I don't know. When I get to build my own kitchen, I'm going to opt for timber tops instead of stone tops, just because that's just me. I don't know. I just like it. It's very soft and organic looking, and I like light kitchens, so I suppose that's why. Doing the dining table here, it's a nice size, this dining room. Actually, this house is a pretty nice size. The rooms aren't too generous, but then they're not too small either, which should be really nice for gameplay. I will probably use this house in my Let's Play, I think, and I think it'll be really nice to kind of for your Sims to move around in and to be easily navigated throughout their everyday activities. Working with some of the base game chairs here, this table is from the Fastlane stuff pack. I really like this table a lot. It comes in a metal color usually, so it's kind of easy to look through the catalog and skip it, but once you kind of retexture it, it can look quite traditional and really nice. Of course, I've colored it orange there. And yeah, just putting in some bookshelves here. An Into the Future bookshelf there. I like using that one because it's just the plainest. It doesn't have kind of any flourishes on it as the Generations one does. And one of these gorgeous chairs from Diesel Stuff Pack. There is actually a lot of Diesel Stuff Pack in this particular build. I don't know, I love those chairs. I love the lamps. They're really cool. And these are the kitchen chairs, which I like. I've used these a lot before. I think they're from Late Night, but they're pretty nice. And putting in the kitchen here, I add a few extra walls in as well to divide the kitchen up a little bit more and kind of for this space to be understood a little bit better, how you're meant to move around in it. And that store item thing keeps popping up. I tried to disable that, but I couldn't find where it was. If one of you guys can tell me in the comments below how to disable that pop-up, that would be fabulous. Because I haven't figured that out yet. Putting in the dividing walls here, I thought it was nice to kind of separate the stove from the rest of the room. Just because, you know, if there's steam coming off a pot that's cooking or whatever, it's kind of nice to have that a little bit secluded, as opposed to kind of steaming all over the room. And putting in some dishwashers and a trash compactor. I always use trash compactors in The Sims, or most of the time, unless I'm building on a budget rather than using just a bin. But I've never been to someone's house with like a full-blown trash compactor that is like the size of a dishwasher. Is that just in Australia we don't have that? Or like, is that something in the US everyone has like a dishwasher and a trash compactor? Like, I don't know. Tell me in the comments below, because for me I find it really strange, but I guess it's pretty cool. Also putting in a lovely blue wall here to kind of, I don't know, make this space a little bit more dynamic, shall we say. And yeah, putting in a diagonal wall there, which I thought was kind of a nice way to seal off that kitchen and to kind of make that room, I don't know, I'm going to use the word dynamic yet again, but it really does make it look a bit more dynamic and not so boxy, I suppose. And yeah, a pillar on the edge there kind of finished it off really nicely, I thought, in my opinion. And this is a nice kind of entrance room. It's just got a nice yellow table there with some, I think I put like a pot plant in it and maybe a chair next to it. So you can kind of walk through that door and fling your bag on the side table. Actually, something I would love to be in The Sims for is if The Sims actually arrived home from work and put their bag on the table, or if they, I don't know, flung their shoes in the corner or something. Something like that would be really realistic, in my opinion. I don't know, it's probably a bit too detailed for the game, but that would be really cool. Or at least maybe some store items that were like a bag that, like a classic looking bag that could suit a lot of different Sims that you could kind of decorate the house with by putting it on the table. I don't know. I thought that was kind of cool. And I love these mirrors from the Diesel Stuff Pack as well. They're really cool. They're just circular ones all put in a row, so they're individual items. They're not just the three of them together. But I've just recolored them in three primary colors, blue, red, and yellow, which is kind of the theme in this house, I guess. There is feature walls of blue, there are feature walls of red, and down on the bottom level there are some feature walls of yellow. But there's definitely hints of yellow throughout the whole house. I've said this before, I like my houses, the colors that I use or the palette I use to kind of be spotted throughout the house. Not necessarily matchy-matchy, but just so there's a connection between the different rooms you kind of walk through. I think that's really important. One of my favorite rugs ever. I think this is from Supernatural. I could be wrong though. I'm not sure, but I love it. And this wall's going to be... Oh, is this wall yellow? Oh no, it's a pastel blue. Yeah, pastel blue is really nice. It's nice and soft and it goes nicely with the orange dining table behind it. It's almost complimentary. And yeah, just using one of the couches from the base game, which I like. I was going to use this rocking chair, but in the end I was like, nah, it's a little bit too old school for my liking. And colouring this chair, which I love. It was from the 70s, 80s, and 90s stuff pack. Such an awesome chair. I want this in real life. I really do. It kind of reminds me of the Ames chair. Just a classic one. I always spend a lot of time recolouring this particular chair because I have so much fun with it, like checking out what I can do with it. And I really like how I've kind of doubled up the pattern here, but I've made a couple of swatches the same, so on the footrest it looks like a slightly different pattern because there's not as much tree illustration going on, but it is the same texture. But yeah, and I do change the carpet to a different one here because I liked the moo-moo. I'm gonna call it the moo-moo carpet. I liked that on the lower level. But yeah, just putting the carpet in, it kind of ties the floor into the wall as well, and putting some shelvings in as well there, which is quite nice. And yeah, I really like this house actually. I really like how it turned out. It's maybe not as mismatched, shall we say, as some of my other interiors, but I kind of like that it's a little bit more simpler this time. You know, the bedside tables match this time around, and the dining chairs match this time around as well. I do get the odd comments here and there where people are like, oh, I really don't like how you mismatch things, or I don't like your style. And yeah, it's cool. Like everyone like each to their own. So maybe this is something that those people might prefer. I don't know. But I certainly like it for a bit of a change. And the Macca's colors are yellow and red, which is very nice. But yes, I love these big windows on each side of the lounge room. I think it would be so nice to sit there and get all that natural light in. And for those people who are always saying use curtains in your interiors, there is curtains in this lounge room. So here we go, putting them in just now. So those with OCD can be happy with that. But not in all the other rooms. The reason why I don't always put curtains in is because they don't fit a lot of the windows in The Sims, and it just frustrates me a little much. And I also like having natural light in my houses too. I don't like how the curtains kind of obstruct that light. But that's just me, I guess. I think it's here that I do have the balls to change the color of the exterior from the brown. I think we're about to dive into it. I just had to black out a section there because I had a bit of YouTube going on. Yeah, so here I go. I'm changing the brown to blue, which was a bold move, but I like it. I think it's cool. If you preferred the other one, feel free to download the house and change it back to that browning color. I think it was also really nice, but something made me want this blue color. Actually, in my Let's Renovate a Starter Home series, it was so funny the amount of people who said, oh my god, Deli, you have made me hate the color blue. I felt so bad, but I don't know. I guess in that household, people really didn't like the exterior blue color change, so hopefully this one is received a little bit better. A little bit funny there. But yeah, I was going to put an architecture kind of sketching table in there, but it was a little bit too bulky, so I went with the keyboard instead, and putting another chair in the corner here. I thought the keyboard was really, really cool because you look out this amazing window and you can like play music to the ocean or... And yeah, just changing the color of the chair here. I really like this chair. It's really cool. It's very... I don't know, you can be really creative with it because it can look both contemporary and it can look really traditional, which is cool. So I kind of merged the two here, which is nice. But yeah, there have been some amazing houses uploaded to the Sim Supply website for this, submitted for this world. They're incredible, some of the builds. you should totally check it out if you haven't already, because it's just fascinating seeing like all the different aesthetics people have from all over the world, like all these simmers and how they deal with these different cliff lots and sloping lots and whatnot. It's pretty cool. I really enjoyed watching a video that kind of picked out some of them on James's channel. That was pretty cool to see them all. But I think I'm going to download quite a few of them myself to have in this world, because it would take me a very, very long time to build this world out by myself. But obviously the other reason is because there are beautiful builds out there already that I would love to use. So well done for those people who have submitted their houses. They are really cool. And making an outdoor balcony area here, which I thought was quite pretty. I do switch it up a little bit here, kind of shuffle it around because I wasn't really sure what I wanted in this spot, but I don't know. It's a nice area. I can imagine sitting out there and relaxing, and I don't know. It's nice. And I love that big plant box. I actually think that's from Into the Future as well. For a futuristic expansion pack, you can use so many of these items as just like current day items because they're so versatile. Once you start, you know, adding different textures and whatnot, you can do such cool things with them. I've honestly been using that expansion pack so much recently. I love it. And I would definitely recommend getting it, actually, even if you're not interested in the gameplay, just for the content. It's a very good expansion pack. And I love this kind of peachy salmon wall here for, I thought this would be a daughter's room, and I thought it was really pretty, kind of these soft colors and those white shelves contrasting against that kind of pinky feature wall is quite nice. Putting in some side tables here that are matching. Whoa. They are not unmatching, they are matching, so that is pretty cool. And those tables are actually also from the Fastlane stuff pack. And they were also originally metal, but then I kind of changed them to a white, like a white and a nice light wooden texture on them, which I thought looked really nice. And they're kind of like a really simple design, so it doesn't overpower or overcrowd the room, if you get what I mean. But yeah, this house actually uses a ton of expansion packs and stuff packs, which I think in my next few videos, I'm going to kind of start selecting just a few to include in each, so the houses are more compatible with you guys' games if you do want to download them. But it also allows me to kind of show you guys what kind of the different expansion packs and stuff packs have to offer if you haven't got them already, so you can kind of get an idea of what's in each of them in case you do want to add them to your game. So I don't know, I guess it's good to change it up a bit and kind of get the best of both worlds, I suppose. But yeah, I love this kind of walk-in wardrobe here. Oh, I guess it's not walk-in, but this kind of clothes wardrobe there that's kind of in the daughter's bedroom. It's quite funny. The daughter's bedroom's like better than the main bedroom. I would say she's quite a spoilt girl. I did have a family in my head for this. I didn't actually create them as Sims for this video, just because I knew I hadn't had a video out for a little while, and because this was actually meant to be out a bit sooner, but because I had some issues with the stairs that took a little while to fix, well, for James to fix, I kind of just decided to kind of just do the build, do the interior, and publish it without showing the sim walking through it this time around. But in my head, it was for a family of parents with a son and a daughter, and the son's a younger boy. He has a downstairs level. It's kind of like a man cave. And the teenage daughter's obviously very spoiled. She's got a beautiful room. And I thought that the parents would kind of be kind of easy, laid back people, maybe musicians that live by the coast, very successful musicians, I might add. And I don't know, I also had this kind of idea in my head that the mother would be an interior designer as well. Because I don't know, the interior in this house is quite clean and pleasant to look at, in my opinion. Doing some of the landscaping again at the front of the house and crisscrossing some of these flower pots here. I thought that was a nice effect, kind of layering them. Yeah, I like them. I also like how the leaves on these plants are like a yellow color for a change. Thought that was really cool, even though I try and obstruct them with those green plants, but then I'm like, oh hell no, we're gonna keep them yellow because they look good. And that orange chair was kind of a nice pop of color, but I kind of ditched that idea. I don't know, looking back on it, maybe I would have kept that. I don't know. I liked it though. But yeah, it's an interesting house. It's different to what I've done, I think. Oh, and sorry, I didn't mean to skip ahead here, but this is a outdoor barbecue area, but you get the idea of what's there, which is quite nice for them to kind of cook different things at and to lounge next to the pool, whilst eating a hot dog, perhaps. I don't know. I'm actually vegetarian, so I don't eat hot dogs. Although there are vegetarian hot dogs, and I don't know, they're kind of good. Like they taste nice. I'm sure they don't taste like real hot dogs, but they're yummy nonetheless. They're okay. Also, I really wanted a pool table in here, and I was struggling to get that in there. So then I just demolished the wall just to fit in the just to fit in the pool table in a second. And yay, I finally got to use these tapestries from Supernatural. Oh, I love them. Like, I seriously love them. I love how you can pick any texture or pattern you want to cover that entire wall. Like, it's so awesome. Oh, love it. But they are quite pricey. Definitely can't use them on a budget. But yeah, just putting them on the wall, I wanted some kind of bold geometric patterns here to kind of offset that bold cowskin rug. So we go with the blue and orange theme here. Just nice, I think. And also this wall, we go for a very bold kind of yellow mangoey color, which is cool. I think the blue, red, and yellow, or blue, orange, and yellow go together really nicely, especially offset with the green in the flower pots too. And yeah, this is another light from Diesel Stuff Pack. I really like that. The only thing I don't like about Diesel Stuff Pack is probably the bed that comes with it and the couch, the white couch and white chair. I don't know if any other people find this, but I feel like they don't really suit. I don't know, they don't suit the graphics of the rest of the game or something. Like, they just remind me of custom content. I don't know, so it really frustrates me. I'm not sure if you guys will know the couch I'm talking about, but it kind of has like a suede-y look about it. And I don't know, I feel like it just doesn't look like the rest of the game items. I don't know. I don't know, that's just me, but it frustrates me a lot, so I just don't really use them, unfortunately. But the rest of it I really like. I love the lights and I love the other chairs and oh, I'm on Skype right now, so I had to kind of cancel out something because I was seeing something that I don't think you guys are meant to see yet. But you will see it soon, I promise. And yeah, putting some shelving in here, which is quite nice, and a lovely column there to kind of separate the break in the shelves. Which is kind of cool. I also love these white boards across some of the walls. I actually did that in the Let's Renovate a Starter Home, so I kind of carried across that idea into this house because it has a very kind of beachy, coastal living look about it, which I really liked. I love these digital photo frames as well. I can't remember if they came from Ambitions or Generations, but I love that you can kind of put any picture in there and you know, have the photo change over time, which is pretty cool. Making a little study area here as well. And I actually put that desk halfway into the wall, which is real. It's one really good thing about cliff building is because you have these big walls that you can't put windows into and that have kind of another wall behind it. So you can hide things in that middle part of those walls, separating the interior from the exterior. So that desk is nicely in line with the bookshelf there, which I do like a lot. And putting in the pool stuff here. Nice pot plant there and a nice little lantern. Probably one of my favorite items from the base game is that little 30 simoleon lantern. I love it. I use it in every house I build. It's awesome. Whoever from The Sims thought of that, I love you. Yep. And at one point, I was like, I really don't like these stools, these kitchen bench stools. And I was trying to figure out you know, a different one to use. But I end up keeping the white ones and get rid of those ones. As you can see, they've kind of reappeared there. But I really wish there were more stools. I guess I could go to the store and buy some stools from a few different packs. But the ones I have, I'm just never satisfied with. I don't know why. And I put a nice big mirror on the back wall there just because there aren't any windows around. And, you know, mirrors kind of add an extra dimension to a room, kind of like what a window would. But obviously it's a mirror, so it's not a window, but, you know, it has that effect. Also, you may have sneakily seen James, because he did fix my house. He decided to floor tile his logo into the basement of the house there. So if you do download this, you will have that in your game, but you can delete it if you would like to. It might offend him, but you know, if you want to, you can. And fixing up the bathroom here, putting some items on the bench, which is quite nice, and another separating wall in there, which I don't know, I like that kind of allowed me to put a mirror in there. Kind of fits in nicely. And working our way down to the very last bottom level, which was really cool for a young boy, for him to age up into a teenage boy. So when he's a teenager, he can have kind of his own space in the house, like a man cave, and have the bees over or whatever. So, but for the moment, it's a child's bedroom. So I don't know, your Sims can age up in this household. So we went with an Into the Future bunk bed, loft bed's the right term, and an Into the Future wardrobe there as well, which I quite like, with a very red accent on there, which definitely ties into the exterior of the house. Putting some shelving in there, or I was attempting to. I think the shelving goes here next to the desk in a second, but I really like making these desks like a white, and then putting really black accents on the legs and on the handles of it. I don't know, I think it looks really rad, especially with that yellow diesel lamp there. It's pretty cool. And that shelf is kind of being slipped down there as a as an area where you can kind of put toys on or toys underneath, and I don't know, I thought that was quite nice. A little storage area amongst those three kind of hidden windows. And yeah, putting in some wallpaper here, kind of go for a blue and a very vibrant yellow color, which is quite nice and sunny and coastal looking. Actually, that was the couch I was talking about from Diesel Stuff Back. Sometimes I do get it out and I'm like, oh, maybe it'll work this time. But then I'm like, no, it's not gonna happen. Those birds that are underneath the bed, they are from the store. They're quite nice, kind of tucked under the bed there. And putting some paintings up on the wall. Love that car painting from Roaring Heights. Ugh, those paintings are awesome from that store pack or store world. Like, they are awesome paintings, because in buy mode you have one painting, but you can actually click on it and select one of several different paintings that the pictures are actually of, which is really cool. Just saving here, which is really important. And yeah, and moving into kind of the stairway room, I guess we could say. There's not really a point of having a door here, but I thought it kind of gave the boy a bit more privacy, so they wouldn't be like yelling up the staircase. And I love this kind of train set that kind of goes on the outside here. It's very like, what's the word? Child friendly, but at the same time very adventurous looking, especially when it's next to all of those rocks kind of piled up on one another, I thought. And also putting a deck chair out here. It's a lovely spot to chill out. But yeah, we're about to go into the screenshots here. But yeah, let me know what you thought about this build, if you liked it, if it was your cup of tea or not. And yeah, this is the exterior of the house. You can kind of see the overall shape of it and the form of it. This is the front of the house accessed from the road. And then, I mean, it looks like a smaller house from the outside, but then once you walk in, you realize it kind of cascades down the cliff edge, which I thought was really cool. The lounge room there, looking very yellow, and oh, look at that view, like, hello, I would oh, I would just love to lie on that chair and just stare out at the ocean. That would be awesome. Such a pretty world. I love it. And also looking at the bathroom here with the beach towel kind of hung up there. It's actually a flag from university life, but you know, who would know? The master bedroom here with matching bedside tables and matching lamps. The downstairs rumpus room, which is pretty cool. The child's room, and I guess we'll be looking at the outdoor area soon as well. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and feel free to download. Let me know if you renovated at all or anything like that. Hope you're having a lovely morning, afternoon, or evening wherever you are, and I'll speak to you soon.